When did you start reading Arendt? Or do you read Arendt?
I think, like I said, my whole work is based in practice, but like let's say it, of course I'm reading besides that, and it was actually in conversation with some people that people pointed me out to some of her work about the human condition and about this idea of speech and action and stuff. So I got curious and I started to read some of it, and also started reading people who wrote about her and how to see, the space of both speech and action, but also this idea about publicness and public life in the public domain. So I was just very interested in it. So I started it maybe like, not completely in the beginning, but so alongside, like also in other writers and stuff, I look for ways in which processes I come across in my practices are described by others, what is actually happening or what's at stake or what's happening there. So I read it as that, so I try to understand it through the lens of some of the writings.
Do you have a favorite book by Arendt? Maybe The Human Condition? Or
Man in Dark Times? No.
And if you had to sum up why Arendt matters, do you have a that's an enormous question.
Yeah, it's a big question.
you're not compelled to answer it.
No, I think Hannah Arendt matters, I think, for very reasons. I think she's a very complex philosopher. Mm-hmm. There's a lot you can agree on and disagree on with her. She's confrontational. So she basically, asks from you that you engage in her thinking and that you find a way to respond to it. And that's actually this idea of she basically forces you to engage with her. Mm-hmm. Maybe that's very strongly said, but I think it is very important. And I like that. So.
Yeah, that's certainly.
She really forces you to engage in her way of seeing the world and to form your own opinion mm-hmm. upon it.
Right, to challenge you to do that.
To challenge to do that.
Anyway, thank you very much.